I wanna have a have my money saved up and have a room by Christmas. Okay. But in the meantime, if it starts snowing tomorrow, I'll go in the shelter. If it snows today, I'll go in the shelter. I'll go in the shelter tonight. Even the paycheck that I get every 2 weeks, I can't even get a room. Right? I'm making $7 an hour. I'm working 4 hours a day. Right? I work part-time. Okay? Get paid every 2 weeks. That money does not subsidize for me getting a room. I got to take money and put it away. You know, to hold on to it. So then I get enough so then, because you know they want first and last. You know, even for a room, not an apartment, a room. You know, it's not easy. It's hard as hell out here. How long is it going to take? It's going to take 3 years. Are we going to end the homeless system 3 years? No. In 5 years? No. In 10? No. Because every day there's somebody else on the street.
We have a policy. We have to get them off the street in the wintertime so they don't, you know, freeze to death or you know, and die, which was, you know, it has happened. There's fewer people on the street because, you know, we more aggressively, you know, get them off the street, get them into, you know, the homeless shelters and so forth.
The role of St. Francis House within Boston's community is to provide not only food, shelter, and clothing, the basic needs, and medical care to the homeless and the very poor, but also to provide valuable rehabilitative services to those people so that they can end their situations. We have really two populations that come to us. We have those who are poor or homeless who have the potential to move beyond their situation, and then we have those people who will never move beyond, whether mental illness or over time trauma of some sort has put them in a situation that they just are unable to take care of themselves and never will be. During the cold months of the year, as the fall approaches and the nights get colder, we see people coming earlier to our doors in the morning, seeking entrance to a warm environment. As the temperatures drop, that time will become earlier and earlier to the point where at times people will sleep all night long outside of St. Francis House hoping to get in. It's easier to be homeless during the summer months when people can spend the days outside. At nighttime, they might find it easier to find somebody to put them up during the winter. It's very difficult. Winter months, people tend to be very closed in their homes, and having an extra person it's very obvious.
Homeless people have been being helped by church groups, have depended upon one another to be safe. And that's a really interesting part of doing what I'm doing. I don't want to say that. It's a very interesting part of the homeless culture is they depend upon one another to be safe. And they're very close-knit groups because they depend on each other for things they need, being safe, things like that. It's a dangerous world.
'Cause I'm the one who loves you. I know you're the best I can. You know I love you. 'Cause I love you more and more each and every day, babe. Open up your heart to me now. Let me in, let me love you. Here I am.
Parks have their rules, but as far as camping out like you asked, this is the closest thing to camping out, but doorways, there really isn't any places where it's safe that you would, as far as safety, you could be near a building that's under construction, something could fly off the roof and The wind could blow something off at night when it's under, you know, wraps, all wrapped up and everything, and you never know. So you have to be careful of where you lay your head at night.
You know? Yes, I love you. I love you, baby. Your own true love. Your own true love. Yes, I love you. I love you, girl. Your own true love.
A lot of deaths this year. I believe that. All right? It's not easy. But we make it. We make it. So-and-so doing so-and-so done.